Hello everyone, welcome to a surprise, kind of a surprise, not really a surprise, Real Future Reviews on Piece by Piece, the newest movie from Morgan Neville about Pharrell Williams and his life and his musical journey. I am joined here today by Ashley.
Hello.
And Karef underscore wins.
Lego Timbaland.
Yeah, of Spirit Guild fame. And basically this movie is, as I have just described it, it is about Pharrell Williams, but in Lego form. And I'm going to let Karef take it away first.
Oh, yeah, I mean, Pharrell Williams' life does seem uninteresting a little bit, right? It's kind of your classic rags to riches story told through the art of Lego, and that actually elevates it quite a bit. I thought this movie was gonna be just like a random biopic like Bohemian Rhapsody or Rocket Man, I guess, although it kind of does the same thing as Rocket Man, where it's able to make kind of this basic story about just like a guy working his way up the chain and then kind of like not finding himself. It makes it interesting. They've got a lot of cool visuals, a lot of nice visual metaphors in the first half. And while I do think it gets a little bit worse in the back half when it has to actually just like be about artists and their relationship to Pharrell Williams, it gets a little bit less like cool and as well visually interesting. But I mean, it's fun. It's kind of a fun time. There's a lot of moments in there that are worth watching the film for. There's a lot of funny visual gags. It's nice.
Yeah, I really liked it too. I had a lot of fun. I really like Pharrell's music in general. So obviously the music in this thing is really, really good. It's all composed by him, and he's composed basically half of pop and hip hop for the past like 30 years or so. I really had a lot of fun watching it and watching him go from just this kid who just really likes music to one of the biggest names in pop. I really enjoyed it. I really liked it.
This is a movie that I was completely perplexed by when I first heard about it. It was sounded like one of those things that would never get made. It is a biopic, but all done in Lego. And it's like, oh, this is this high concept thing that no studio really wants to produce because it's like a little bit much and it's going to be expensive because it's animation. This seemed like something that was never going to happen, because you see like all those projects on IMDb where it's like, oh, this is crazy weird concept, and then it just sits there forever because it's never going to come out. It's stuck in production hell. So it was very pleasant surprise to see that this was actually legit. And when that first trailer came out, I was like, wow, this is such a weird unique concept for one of these biopics. I really wasn't expecting like a Bohemian Rhapsody or a Rocket Man out of it. I was expecting just kind of a straight up retelling of Pharrell Williams' life. But the Lego aspect of it does a lot of the heavy lifting. It does a lot of the heavy lifting, and I would definitely not have checked this out otherwise. And as I was watching it, it was almost like the Lego part started to fade away, and I wasn't necessarily getting bored, but I was like, they did creative things with the fact that it was made with Lego, and I understand that thematically there is a reason for it to be done with Lego, because he's literally piecing the music together, he's piecing his life together, he's building it up. He explains that kind of in the beginning of the movie, where he's talking about why he'd want to make it all in Lego. It's just a fun, unique concept. His music is great. I mean, the dude is a genius with beats. And I will say, it was awesome to see Virginia Beach and see so much love for the state of Virginia in this movie. This is a state that gets overlooked a lot, right? And it doesn't have great tax incentives for filmmakers to come here. So whenever there is an opportunity or whenever it happens, it's like, it's a really exciting thing. It's a big deal. I think the state really needs to step itself up, because honestly, there's a lot of beautiful locations here. They need to start giving better tax incentives to these filmmakers to come out here, because I know there's a lot of them that would like to. They just, you know, why go film there? We can go film in Georgia and save a lot of money.
Yeah, like Vampire Diaries takes place in Virginia, but it's filmed in Georgia.
There's a lot of stuff filmed in Georgia. Yeah, they offer really good tax incentives down there.
Mm-hmm.
Kara, I just want you to know that Mount Trashmore is a real place. I have been there.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's a genuine real place. It's literally used to be a landfill, and then they made it into a park. And there's this ginormous hill that you can go stand on. So that's a real place. Just want to let you know. Also, okay. The giant talking Neptune statue, that's also real. It does
that.
Talk. No, I'm just kidding. But there is a giant Neptune statue down there on the beach. But the other thing I was surprised to see, that how many pop artists and rappers came out of that area, like, around the same time. Like, I was like, Missy Elliott's from Virginia? I had no idea. I've never heard of that guy before, but I've heard of Missy Elliott at least. I didn't ever hear of Chad, but he sounds like he's just more of a behind the scenes kind of guy.
Yeah, he's like the second person in the Neptunes.
Yeah.
From what I got, but it might just be that, like, you know, the movie is about Pharrell, and so while Chad is an important role, it's like more about Pharrell's, like,
his creative, you know, process.
Stuff. Yeah, yeah.
It is kind of a generic. Like, the actual content itself is sort of a generic biopic or whatever, like an autobiography or whatever you want to call it. It's just an interview. The whole movie is framed around interviews, but it's all done in Lego so they can do all these fun and crazy visuals. So, like I said at the beginning of this, the Lego aspect does a lot of the heavy lifting. Is it worth it to see it for that? I mean, if you're a Pharrell Williams fan, it's going to be worth seeing, right? And I would say if you live in Virginia, it might be worth seeing, because it is interesting to see stuff from Virginia Beach portrayed on the big screen or have Virginia talked about in such a positive way. That was really nice to see. It really was. I was surprised to hear he came from here.
One thing that I think the Lego part kind of doesn't really work is that a lot of the characters start to look the same. Like, they have some defining characteristics about them, but when they start, like, being the same skin tone and having the same face and the same hairstyles, it can get difficult to tell the characters apart from one another.
One of the other things that is like, a very minor thing, but is just strange, is that there's a lot of, like, Legos and bikinis in this movie, and that is...
That didn't really bother me, man. I thought it was actually really funny.
It's just a strange thing.
Well, like, they're remaking real footage.
Yeah, yeah. Those parts are, like, for the real footage parts, right? And yeah, it's just weird. I think my favorite gag in the movie is the PG gas.
Oh, right. So yeah, the Snoop Dogg stuff was really funny. They even make a really blank and you'll miss it, and I don't even think you guys know that this exists, but Snoop Dogg has, like, a sort of, not really Coco Melon-ish, but he has, like, a little animated thing on YouTube, and there is a specific thing he says in this movie that he says in that animated thing. Like, it's like, I don't know. I can't explain it. I'll send you guys the video or one of the videos later, but I was like, oh my God, that is such a deep cut reference to that thing. Maybe this is just, like, something he's always said and I just didn't hear it until he started doing those animated things, but that's just a fun little thing I picked up on. Of course, they make Snoop Dogg into an actual dog for a few moments in the movie, which they...
Well, they're not high. Yeah.
Yeah, which they...
blatantly not high.
It was just fine. If you're a Pharrell Williams fan, I would say go see it. If you are from Virginia, I'd say there's a lot there for you to enjoy just by the fact that a lot of it takes place in Virginia. It's in Lego form, but a lot more of this movie was revolving around Virginia than I expected. Like, I was kind of waiting for them to, like, quickly move on and move on to him, like, going out to Los Angeles and becoming this big star. But that's, like, kind of a smaller part of the movie. This is mostly about Pharrell Williams, like, upbringing and kind of what molded him into being that star to begin with. And even at the end, it rounds out with him coming back to Virginia. It sounds like he lived here for quite a while before moving away.
Yeah, like, the record label comes to Virginia Beach. He doesn't go to L.A. They go to him, metaphorically speaking. But basically, like, it seems like a lot of the time people are coming to Pharrell because they hear about him from other artists. And that's definitely really cool. But the initial record label sets up in Virginia, like, right down the road from his high school. And they specifically go to the high school and be like, hey, there's some talent here. And that's how a lot of the people get picked up.
Pharrell is a very talented individual, but he also got extremely lucky that they just so happened to, like, set up shop right down the road.
And that's one of the things that is weird about the movie for me, because it feels like half of the movie is this kind of, like, Pharrell Williams, like, wonder tour, but without a lot of self-reflection. It's just about his rise, and he doesn't really have a ton of time to, like, you know, look inwards, find his flaws, or, you know,
whenever he
and,
has
and everybody's
his fall,
juicing him up.
It's not his fault. It's like, it's the executive's fault. They made him do it.
Yeah, faceless executives too. There's no names for multiple reasons, but, like, yeah, it's kind of hard to get invested in that.
And there's, like, a whole montage where he's just, like, annoying a bunch of people until someone pays attention to him, and it's like, oh, okay, yeah, realistically, this isn't how this happened, probably.
And you get a little bit of that from, like, the other interviews. They're all, like, saying, like, oh, sometimes he's a dork, right? And or, you know, sometimes he flies too close to the clouds, but they always come back. Like, there are a lot of moments when other artists are talking about him where they're like, the first time I saw him, I was like, whoa, that's incredible. And I don't doubt that he was good at making music, like really good, right? Because I've heard it and it's good. But at the same time, it does feel like some of the tougher aspects of his life are less in focus. Like, when his grandmother dies, it feels like kind of out of left field, and I get that it probably happened in that order, but, like, you don't really see the buildup of his grandmother being a huge part of his life for that to really hit hard. Right.
You see it a little bit when he was a kid, like she would take him to church and he got really into the music through that, and she gave him his first snare drum and stuff like that. But other than that, like other than his childhood specifically, you don't really see her again after that.
I wonder how many biopics are going to try to do this weird thing where they try to find some really extreme weird style, like Pharrell did Lego. What's the next?
And now we got this freaking monkey movie.
Oh,
that's the next one.
Oh, right. Yeah.
Oh,
I completely forgot.
Yeah.
Monkey Man. Yeah. It's like, ah, oh, it's the exact thing, but except I'm a monkey because reasons. I mean, I guess they were like, well, we need a new hook, new gimmick to get people to watch these kinds of movies, because unless you're a super fan, you're not really going to care. And like I said, the only reason I saw this is because of the Lego aspect of it. That's really what drew me in. And while that does kind of fade away for me, like, at a certain point, the gimmick doesn't work as well anymore. The novelty of it wears off. And
well, it's because they don't do, like, more visual metaphors in the second half, right? Because it opens on a scene where he's literally in the water getting blessed by Neptune. And we got that rocket ship, and we got all the, like, child creativity stuff. We got him looking into the speakers. That's all visually interesting, and we get less of that as the movie goes on, I feel like.
Yeah, we get, like, one shot of Lego Minions, and then they never bring up the Despicable Me movies. They don't even say them by name. They don't even say Illumination. They show the Minions. You can figure it out, but the fact that his music's so tied to those Despicable Me and I think other Illumination films, and they don't really talk about that at all, is weird.
We didn't get a Chris Meledandri Lego minifigure. We don't get any actual Lego minifigures out of this, by the way. I checked the Lego store to see if they were doing anything for it, and they just, nope. They actually have a Wicked set. And quick aside,
there was
see this movie, they did the whole trailer for what? It feels like it was kind of an expensive production too, because it's using real pieces from what I can tell.
It's all animated, but they're based off of real pieces, right?
Yeah, but they actually stop motion the faces in the Wicked trailer, which they don't do for the movie. I don't know, it feels like somebody's pet project that was allowed to show in theaters, but that's awesome. It was really funny. Like,
so it's out of nowhere too, like it's not even part of the movie, it's there, it just happens.
I really want them to make a Lego set of that big Neptune statue. I think that would be so fun, but it's not gonna happen probably.
You could just make it like everything in that movie you could make with actual Legos. They have like
except for the minifigures.
Yeah, but I mean everything else, like the buildings and the cars and everything, those are all based on real Legos that you could just make. So that's all I gotta say. Do you guys have any final words? Do you recommend this? Do you not recommend it?
I do.
Kendrick Lamar Lego. I would say go watch it if you want to. Like, it's totally fine. It's a pretty fun movie. It's not gonna blow you away, but it's totally worth admission.
I'm not really sure where this fits in with the rest of the Lego movie cinematic universe. They didn't really reference like Emmett or Lucy Wildstyle or Batman or any of the other guys. No Lego Ninjago, so I'm not sure where it's supposed to fit in there. If they make another Lego movie, I will not be surprised if they make a joke about this biopic at some point. Yeah, it's just a very strange, wild idea, but I think that just kind of fits with Pharrell Williams, where he just has all these strange, wild ideas that just end up working. They end up hitting. I will say that despite it being a Saturday morning, Ashley and I were the only two in the theater, but this movie's also been out for a week, so.
I went on Thursday morning and we were the only two in the theater.
That's so weird.
Me and film bro friend. Yeah.
Considering it's like an animated movie, and it's also based on a major pop star. Oh, Care. I noticed they didn't talk about the Amazing Spider-Man 2 soundtrack.
They didn't. You know what else they kind of skirted around?
Yeah.
Blurred Lines. Like, they play the song.
Thinking that, too. Yes.
Wait.
Like, they didn't interview Robin Thicke.
Oh,
they
didn't.
I mean, Robin
that's the one they stole, right?
Yeah, yeah, the lawsuit. And I think it happens right after he says he wanted to try something new, too, which is crazy.
Lol.
You know what was also crazy? So there's like a moment where they're showing like the music charts and there's like a P. Diddy song up there. And I was like, oh, man.
Oh, yeah. And then Kanye West is up for best producer of the year. You know, like,
I mean, it's just it's a bunch the of facts stuff, of what happened, right? Like, you can't.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, I guess that's it. Thank you guys for watching. Yeah.